You probably know that the most common culprits for the air suspension fault or air suspension system fault warnings are air struts and air pump in the suspension system of Audi vehicles, but when it comes to the A8 model, the repair and even inspection may cost you a crazy amount of money, so it's worth checking these issues step by step and not relying completely on what dealerships may tell you. The problem is that dealerships and some indie shops tend to throw parts at the air suspension hoping that they will guess and the problem will disappear. Diagnosing the struts, the control module and the pump in the air suspension is quite difficult, so there are tons of badly diagnosed cars that take thousands of dollars in parts and labor costs to just throw that warning again after several hours of driving. So what should you start with? The first thing to inspect is the set of suspension height sensors. Each strut in your air suspension is fitted with the height sensor. It's used for headlight leveling system, but its primary goal is to communicate with the air suspension control modules and tell them about the height of the certain strut at a certain moment. When these sensors go bad, they don't always set the codes. Sometimes they keep sending wrong readings and you will never guess that the problem is with the sensor until you at least look at it carefully. Sometimes these sensors develop significant play or even get disconnected and you can visually confirm that a certain sensor needs replacement. One sensor costs 50 to 100 euros depending on what brand you choose, so it's not a very expensive repair. Also, if your car leans on one wheel when you see the air suspension warning on the dash, this is a good hint and you can try replacing that height sensor and then clearing the codes to see if this fixes the issue. Other than that, after the Audi vehicle reaches about a decade of age, the air strut seals start losing their shape and one of the struts may start leaking. If this is the case, you will need a new strut, but this is anyway not a DIY repair. One of the big red flags when you let professional mechanics diagnose the vehicle is when they come up with a big list of things that you need to replace, like the strut, the module, the sensor, and also wires. Now, this most likely means that they just want to replace everything that can potentially cause this problem without properly inspecting the car. Now, given the prices for air suspension components are crazily high, you will always want to get a second opinion in such cases.